topic is different food components, excess of carbohydrates stored in liver muscles in the form of glycogen. Proteins are macromolecules formed by bonding together many amino acids. Now, macromolecule is a big molecule. Proteins of animal origin are called as first class proteins. We get 4 kilocalories of energy per gram of protein. So, and proteins gives us how many calorie energy? It is 4 kilocalorie energy. After digestion of proteins, amino acid is obtained. Now, this amino acid is further absorbed in body and transported up to each organ via blood. From this amino acid, organs and cells produce various proteins necessary for themselves. Next, we'll see protein and different amino acids obtained. First is skin, melanin, keratin, bone, ossin, cells, various proteins, cell membrane, various enzymes, pancreas, insulin and trypsin, pituitary glands, various hormones, muscles, actin, myosin, flexible proteins, and blood gives hemoglobin and antibodies. Always remember, excess of amino acid obtained from protein is not stored in body. So, they are not stored in body. They are always broken down and eliminated out of the body in the form of ammonia. So, they are given out of the body in the form of ammonia. What is gluconeogenesis? If necessary, the excess proteins are converted into useful substance like glucose throughout the process of gluconeogenesis. Plants produce necessary amino acids from minerals, then evolve and thereby produce different plants protein. An enzyme, Ribisco, present in plant chloroplast is most abundant protein found in nature. Abundant means in the large quantity. From where do the lipids is obtained? What is lipids? The substance is formed by specific chemical bonds between fatty acids and alcohol. Now, the substances obtained by specific chemical bonds between fatty acids and alcohol is called as lipids. Now, after the digestion of lipids is converted into fatty acids and alcohol. Now, further, this fatty acids goes to different cells, produce various substances necessary for themselves. For example, molecules called as phospholipids, which are essential for producing plasma membrane. Now, plasma membrane is also known as cell membrane, are formed from the fatty acid. Fatty acids are used for producing hormones like progesterone, estrogen, testosterone and aldosterone, etc., covering around the axons of the nerve cells. We get 9 kilocal of energy per grams of lipids. Excess of lipids is stored in adipose connective tissue in the body. Now, in some people we experience difficulty in seeing in night, or while eating something we feel like we have got a mouth ulcer, so we can't eat the food. Why it is? So, it is due to the vitamins, lack of vitamins. So, why vitamins are necessary for our body? The vitamins are the group of heterogeneous compounds of which each is essential for proper operation of various processes in the body. There are main 6 types of vitamins, that is vitamin A, B, C, D, E and K. Out of this, A, D, E and K are fat soluble. Fat soluble means it's soluble in oil, whereas B and C are soluble in water. So they are called as water soluble. FADH2 and NADH2 are produced in the process of glycolysis and Krebs cycle. Vitamins like riboflavin, vitamin B2 and nicotinamide, vitamin B5 respectively are necessary for the production. Now we'll have a quick recap on our today's topic, that is energy from different food components. Now, excess of carbohydrates stored in livers and muscles in the form of glycogen. Proteins are macromolecules.
formed by bonding together many amino acids. Proteins of animal origin are called as first-class proteins. We get 4 kilocal of energy per gram of proteins. Amino acid obtained after digestion of protein. It is absorbed in body and transported up to each organ and cell via blood. From this amino acid, organs and cells produce various proteins necessary for themselves. Now we'll see proteins and different amino acid obtained. Skin, melanin, keratin, bone, osteine, cells, various protein, cell membrane, various enzymes, pancreas, insulin, trypsin, pituitary gland, various hormones, muscles, actin and myosin, flexible proteins, blood, hemoglobin and antibodies. Always remember, excess of amino acid obtained from protein is not stored in body. They are broken down and eliminated out of the body in the form of ammonia. What is gluconeogenesis? If necessary, the proteins are excess proteins are converted into other useful substance like glucose through the process of gluconeogenesis. Plants produce necessary amino acids from mineral de novo and thereby produce different proteins. Enzymes Ribisco present in plant chloroplast is more abundant protein found in the nature. From where do we obtain the lipid? What is lipids? Lipids formed by a specific chemical bonds between fatty acids and alcohol. Digestion of lipid consumed by us, conversion of fatty acids and alcohol. From those fatty acids, different cells produce various substances necessary for themselves. Example, molecules called as phospholipids, which are essential for producing plasma membrane, cell membrane, are formed from fatty acids. Fatty acids are used for producing hormones like progesterone, estrogen, testosterone, and aldosterone, and covering around the axons of the nerve cells. We get 9 kilocal of energy per grams of lipids. Excess of lipids are stored in adipose connective tissue in the body. Why vitamins are necessary for our body? Vitamins are the group of heterogeneous compounds in which is essential for proper operation of the various processes in the body. There are 6 main types of vitamin, example A, B, C, D, E and K. Out of this, A, D, E and K are fat soluble, whereas B and C are water soluble. FADH2 and NADH2 are produced in process like glycolysis and Krebs cycle. Vitamins like riboflavin, vitamin B2 and nicotinamide, vitamin B5 respectively are necessary for production.